Tums. Hi, I'm Jaymee Sire, and welcome to The Dish, presented by Tums, where we make some of your favorite game day recipes from around the Pac-12. Today's dish is the Jaymee Sirewich from Ike's Place. As you can tell by the name, this is something near and dear to my heart, but it's also something that should be quite familiar to several Pac-12 fans. There's one on the campus of Stanford, another on the campus of ASU, there's also one in downtown Berkeley, and another in Los Angeles, as well as several others across the country. For a Jaymee Sirewich, you need some fried chicken. We're using chicken tenders today. You can definitely make your own homemade fried chicken if you'd like. So let's start by making some golden barbecue sauce. What that means is it's just a yellow barbecue sauce, a mustard-based barbecue sauce, similar to what you would find in the Carolinas. So, of course, we need to have a little bit of mustard to start. Then to add the sweetness, I'm gonna add a little bit of brown sugar, about 2 tablespoons, and 2 tablespoons of honey as well. I'm using a spicy honey. The spicy honey will give it just a little bit more of a kick, which is what I like. And we're also going to add just some spices, some granulated garlic, onion, cayenne, and a little bit of kosher salt as well. All of Ike's sandwiches come with his signature dirty sauce. The recipe is top secret. It's some sort of garlic aioli situation. Not exactly sure, but we're gonna start with what we know, the mayo. We're also going to add the garlic because that is a strong taste in this sauce as well. A couple pinches of that. We do wanna give it a little bit of a kick. So, a little bit of cayenne. All right, let's give it a taste. Tastes pretty good to me, so we're gonna go with that. All right, so we're adding our dirty sauce to our sandwich roll, and what they do at Ike's Place is actually kind of bake this right into the bread. So we're going to achieve that by running it under the broiler for just 1 or 2 minutes. All right, now we have our dirty sauce kind of baked and toasted into the bread. We'll add some fried chicken, or in our case, some chicken tenders. And then we are going to add some pepper jack cheese. I like a lot of cheese. All right, so I'm going to put this side back in the oven for a little bit just to melt the cheese. We have our yellow barbecue sauce that we made from scratch. So we will just drizzle that over the top. Now, just a little word of warning, if you've never had an Ike's sandwich, they are very messy, so don't be shy. All right, we have our shreddice on there, shredded lettuce. You can also add things like pickles, jalapenos, and then top this off with a little bit of ranch dressing. People always ask me if I got to pick out my sandwich at Ike's Place, and the answer is yes, I did. I actually went in for a tasting. We had a bunch of different options, and this is the one that I liked the best. All right. Time for the best part, taste test. Let's see how close I got to the Ike's Place Jaymee Sirewich. All right, we got chicken, we've got golden barbecue sauce, creamy ranch dressing, some shredded lettuce. I'm going in. I mean, pretty much exactly how I remember it at Ike's Place. So definitely try to recreate this at home. Let me know if you do, and we'll see you next time on The Dish.